It's Shin versus Hashimoto. We are so excited about it because it's one of the great joys in any sport is seeing somebody emerge absolutely out of nowhere. It's not like she's come from the chasing pack of contenders here. She's come from absolutely rank outsider status to be really well positioned in the semi-final.
I mean, having to fight through the qualification rounds, but look at this here. She looked there so unfazed against Shin Yubin's forehand.
A really interesting feature, Fraser, the dynamic of this match is that you have here in Shin a player who is obviously the favourite, obviously expected to win it. However, she's never beaten her. And sometimes the pressure can do funny things to people, can't it? Sometimes being the favourite is not a nice place to be.
Exactly. And relatively Hashimoto in better form. The Olympics is less than 3 weeks from beginning. Shin Yubin will be featuring there as Korea's leading lady. Hashimoto won't even be featuring in women's team. All the pressure is on Shin Yubin.
One of the strongest features of Hashimoto's game that we've seen over the course of this week is her extraordinary physical conditioning. She can just keep running and running and running for hours.
She's relentless, honestly. It's incredible how quickly she glides in and out, how much ground she covers. Now, Shin Yubin didn't play with much freedom in the women's doubles final. A lot of people were wondering, was that because it was doubles and she didn't really have the flexibility? I mean, it was such a unique experience against two defenders for Jin and Shin, who, of course, are vice world champions. So now is the real test. If you lose, it's completely down to you in singles. But you do have more freedom in terms of where you can serve, of course, in terms of how you can move. We'll see how Shin can cope. What a serve from Hashimoto. This serve here is a serve that Sohyo won, Hashimoto and Sato will have. A high toss, really spinny backhand serve, which is perfect to play as a defender.
5-4.
So difficult to time though.
It will be interesting to see where Hashimoto's ranking goes after the conclusion of this tournament.
If she won this match, she could more than half it. Currently on 130 points, the Japanese player.
4-7.
She has won a couple of singles titles. Croatia Open in 2017, the Spanish Open of 2020. But a totally different sort of singles record compared to Shin Yubin. That's what makes this so fascinating. At the moment, Hashimoto is not finding her length in the way that she has done in her previous matches.
I mean, it's been a while since she played, and I think that she'll just be trying to get used to the contact of Shin Yubin. Each player has a very different contact. Oh, again, she burns Shin Yubin out to the wide forehand, continuously pushing. Notices Shin's going to spin it and comes in, blocking it, twiddling to be able to do that.
there it is. That ability she's got to produce a judicious attacking shot.
And it's the juxtaposition. Koshin has overall a stronger attack, but it's that contrast that the modern defender creates. Ooh, just overcooks that, Shin Yubin. Is that a bit of impatience or is that a bit of nervousness? Is that a bit of desperation to be able to guarantee a two-point cushion? This is a test of patience.
That's unfortunate on Hashimoto.
But she does look like she's finding her feet, just finding her flow state with the chops now, doesn't it? That length you were talking about.
Yeah, it's interesting how it's just changed over a few points.
Mm. Oh, went for it again. Good play from Shin Yubin. Two game points.
You get the sense in a match like this that the overwhelming emotion for Shin, if she can win the game, win the match, will just be relief because it's arduous playing Hashimoto. It's not arduous watching her, it's great fun. Not quite. Shin winning the first, 11-8.
One love.
She played a lot of balls in that first game down the mid-region of the table, Shin Yubin, and I'm wondering, can she really exploit the angle? Can she move Hashimoto wide to either side just to open up the table for her? Make a finishing shot a little bit easier.
Whoever it is that is victorious in this match is going to have a tough time of things based on what we saw in the first semi-final against Ito Mima.
One, two.
Yeah, I mean, the way that she beat Sergio on earlier, Ito, it'd be tough to imagine either Hashimoto or Shin Yubin winning this event.
But then we've spent an entire tournament thinking ahead of every Hashimoto match. It's tough to imagine her winning this one.
And she's done it. What an achievement here for the 26-year-old.
Two days ago as well. I mean, that's the other lovely feature of this. It's been a birthday celebration competition for her.
And beating Miwa Hadamoto, her best career win to date, was a very nice little treat for herself. Covers the edge.
Two, four.
Look out for a reaction. An ability to improvise. I mean, there's no doubt that the movement of Hashimoto is more dynamic. And I'm not just saying that because she's a defender. I'm saying that because I've barely ever seen her flat-footed. I've barely ever seen her plant her feet before she knows what shot the opponent's going to play.
Oh, goodness me. I was surprised the camera managed to have enough zoom to get far back to keep Hashimoto in shot there. It's extraordinary.
Wow, how fast is that chop. Xin Yubin barely has any time, and she's the attacker. And she's chopping that with the inverted rubber. Look how she serves with it as well to generate more spin and then twiddles to get the pimples on the backhand. Whoa.
Consider yourself privileged. You've just had the Dictionary of Table Tennis read aloud to you. Every conceivable shot was played there. That's incredible.
Well, I don't know how much the tickets were, but I would have just spent all my money to watch that single point on repeat. Unbelievable. What we're seeing is Xin Yubin try and hit a few of them too flat. I think that she's feeling uncomfortable, but she's got to keep the rotation on the ball, the quality on the ball.
I just go back to one of the things that we said at the very start of the match about Hashimoto, her athleticism, her conditioning, her ability to run and run and run and then not gasp for breath at all, to still have control in how she plays her shots. It means that if you are going to beat her, you're not going to wear her down athletically. You might wear her down in terms of the shot selection that she's forced to deploy, but you're not going to get her gasping for breath very easily.
I mean, look at her. She's barely breaking a sweat.
Five.
Nice receive from Xin Yubin. If she can play a higher trajectory, slower ball with her backhand into the forehand of Hashimoto, it'll be difficult for the Japanese chopper to chop it quickly. So Xin Yubin here, initially in the rally by playing the ball slower, will give her definitely a tactical advantage.
6-8.
That was better, you see. Seven, you see there. Eight. If she attacks straight away, that's exactly what Hashimoto's looking for. Wouldn't be surprised to see a timeout.
Timeout.
There we go. Well spotted.
Pureness to her fighting spirit. Usually defenders are more unassuming in the way they go about her business, and that's synonymous with her character. That's what I like about her. I mean, Xin is more of a big fish in a smaller pond, and I wonder how much she's enjoying this contest right now at this moment in time.
At nine.
She'll enjoy it significantly more if she can just get through this game. Hashimoto had a very compelling lead. And if Xin is able to turn this game around, this will be massive credit to the 19-year-old from the Republic of Korea.
Clever side spin chop with a little bit of after motion there that created just a last split second kick to the side. The fact that it was placed where it was, more into the mid region as well, just stalled Xin Yubin. That was a clever shot there from Hashimoto. She may have expected a punch or something quicker.
Two! No, not in a million years. You could see it, how quickly Hashimoto was going to get to the table. And she knew, didn't she, from the moment that she played it.
Put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Game point, Hashimoto.
Ooh, well, well, well. Shin Yubin's heart must have skipped a beat there. It was good placement from the Korean.
Another one for Hashimoto. Potential turning point in the match here.
Very interesting game now.
It's becoming the sort of game where you feel psychologically for Shin, if she can win this game, then suddenly she's the favourite overwhelmingly to win it, to book a place in the final. Is absolutely remarkable.
It was perfect from Shin Yubin, opening the body, but she just lost her posture on the ball where she really needed it. A ball with backspin, but a ball high enough to attack.
Game point number three. On we go, 12 all.
You've got to meet the ball at exactly the right moment. You can see Shin Yubin just pampering herself and telling herself to, you know, take the ball in front of herself, but still really use the legs, use the waist, use the back to create the power. It doesn't all come from the arm.
This time, Hashimoto goes long, and Shin has a first game point. She has saved three. This is one of those games, isn't it, Fraser? It's one of those games.
26 scintillating exchanges. It's tough to say who'd regret losing this game more at this point now.
Hashimoto 13, gets a fourth 14. Opportunity to win the game.
You have to imagine it'd be Hashimoto, I guess, with the number of game points that she's had.
Shin 14. Has done brilliantly to save this yet again. We've talked about this very much from Hashimoto's perspective, but just a word or two on Shin here. Well, she has fought hard, hasn't she, in this game?
Yeah. She has. Delaying the inevitable there with a long, fast serve. Most aggressive combo she could have gone for. That initial one that she chops has no spin on it. The more you loop into Hashimoto's chops, the heavier and heavier the ball gets to lift. Another game point for her.
She has the game. 15, 14, the biggest response we've seen vocally. Shin Yubin. But Hashimoto got through with the fifth attempt.
One love.
A seesawing sense of momentum in this match.
I feel like Shin is getting to a stage where so many of her attacks have been returned by Hashimoto, not just in this match, but in the women's doubles final. She may begin to feel powerless, but what she needs to do is attack less, if that's the case.
She varies things, doesn't she, cleverly, Hashimoto?
There's something counterintuitive about playing a defender that is actually one of the reasons why they're so effective. By
1-3.
And this is from the perspective of the attacker. Shin Yubin may win this match sooner and easier if she attacks less, if she's less aggressive. And that's something that she's got to realise here.
But the problem with that is it is, as you say, it's so utterly counterintuitive that it must be very difficult to actually inhabit that mindset.
Yes, it is extremely difficult. The reason why no one's beaten Hashimoto this event yet. I mean, we talk about the best defenders in the world, Sato, Han Ying. Hashimoto right now could be the most informed chopper out there. Linda Bergstrom, another very good chopper from Sweden. But it's that intimacy, it's that elegance that we've loved to see.
She's a tremendously graceful player, isn't she?
Oh, to say the least. Shin Yubin played a much better point there because she didn't slap. She kept the rotation on the ball. That won't happen that many times right there. That was an exceptional forehand. Wow.
Lovely angle.
And the understanding of her own equipment to be able to do that against that ball. An understanding of what was possible off the Shin Yubin shallower receive. Constantly going against the grain. That's not the right one to do that to. Just because it's high doesn't mean it's slappable. We saw Ito earlier making that mistake a few times, but she quickly learned from it. That was better from her. She just opened up the bat and body a little bit more. It's very difficult to describe how much backspin is on this, but if, for example, someone who'd never played before put their bat to try and attack what Hashimoto just did, the ball would drop right off and hit their side of the table.
6-5.
Once again, we have a situation where Hashimoto's early lead in the game is being eaten away.
Two. 5-7.
That was fortunate. No wonder Hashimoto reacts as she did. She was practically sitting in the front row.
It's amazing how she's returning these balls. Mind-boggling. But again, Shin could win the point an easier way than that. And as a top 10 player, that's something she should know.
Just pressurizes you, doesn't she?
That one there just dinks it into the crossover point.
She's just such a secure player technically, and it must be horrible to face if you're starting to doubt yourself.
Which Shin is. You can see it.
Well, this is different. She had 5 game points in the last, but these are consecutive.
11-5.
And she takes it straight away.
One love.
There is the natural struggle of winning any sporting contest that always tests a person's mentality. But there's also the test that you get from a player like Hashimoto, which is a particular kind of test. It's the relentlessness and the reliability of Hashimoto.
And you know you're up against that before the point even begins. I mean, she just relishes in the ecstasy of combat, the chopper. And she enjoys the fact that each point is a brand new leaf.
1-2.
It would be interesting to go back and actually look at across the entire tournament, if one has several days to do so, at how many completely free soft points Hashimoto has actually given away in the entire competition. How much she's made all of her opponents work for every single point. And Shin Yubin now has used her timeout. She's nearly there, Hashimoto. But also, there is still some way to go. What has been, Fraser, so striking about Hashimoto in all of her matches is she has not become fearful as the moment of victory has approached.
It could have all been over against Miwa Hatamoto, who I think had a game point to go 2-0 up against her. She played one of the rallies of the event to save it. She's so present. She's not thinking about the consequence of win or loss. And despite being the lower-ranked player, I think that her experience certainly helped that. As well as the mentality that she is, well, that she has, sorry, as a defender.
3-4.
It's a really interesting concept, isn't it? And it's spoken a lot of in all racket sports, the idea of just play the point. And then that point finishes, forget about it, play the next point. It's one of the most prized skills to have mentally, isn't it?
Yeah. It's probably the best skill. The ability to just ground yourself like that. completely.
Five, four.
Better there, more empty loop from Shin Yubin. That was what we knew could be helpful for her. It just helps her easily lift the backspin, and it's tougher then for Hashimoto to make a quality chop. Smarter from Shin. And four, that's six. The first backhand topspin I can recall her trying, and she misses it. Obviously not so confident to take it on, Shin Yubin. Has the serves here now, the Korean. We haven't seen many wide serves. They've all been kind of down the mid region of the table. Another one here.
Four, seven.
And well, Hashimoto again. Just chiseling that ball. Three ahead, four away from becoming the lowest ranked player to ever reach a final of a star contender.
That time, she couldn't quite get there, but it's been a rare thing in this tournament. This is absolutely extraordinary. This is one of the stories of the season.
Six,
no matter what happens here, she's on everybody's radar now, Hashimoto. She has to make her move, Shin Yubin. She has to stay relaxed here. 6-8.
Well, seven, this is intriguing. Eight. Shin is getting back into this game.
Nine, seven.
2 points. That is all.
Nine, eight.
Body language of Hashimoto there. She was willing that to drop. Very useful and timely intervention from Shin. It takes it to 9 apiece. And now the pressure really is on Hashimoto, who doesn't have a timeout to use.
But the amount of serves that have been received from Hashimoto, and that's another beautiful thing about the defensive style, means that there is so much pressure on Shin Yubin here. To be able to keep it simple in this moment.
Here is
10.
The the big moment. Hashimoto Honoka has match point.
She did so well there, Shin Yubin, because she was up against backspin, she was up against floats, and she kept the posture there, stayed low, read it, didn't go too big, didn't lose the presence mentally or composure, and saves match point.
Another one that goes marginally Hashimoto's way. It's a second match point for the world number 139. But not yet.
That was the ball.
11,
that
12.
Was the ball. And she's made far too many mistakes on. You've got to get over that more, Shin Yubin. Can Hashimoto take it this time to guarantee a Japanese winner of this star contender Bangkok?
Fantasy to reality.
Game and
it's one of the stories.